trash. We generate over 2 billion tons of it every year, 80% of which will end up incinerated or in landfill. In China, that figure is even higher, 98% according to the World Bank. But the country is experimenting with solutions to sort and recycle. Auntie Jane, for example, is one of over 300,000 trash sorters in the city of Chengdu. She's been helping residents at this compound for around a year now.
In the beginning, they put their kitchen waste in with everything else, but I will tell them and they will see the posters. So they know now, and when they bring it out, it's already sorted. Kitchen waste, residual and recycling.
It's taken time for residents to build these new habits.
We have some glass bottles, some cardboard bags.
But it's a start, and it's just one of several solutions around the city.
In this older residential community, closer to the city centre, they're experimenting with their own recycling solution, and it involves a cash incentive.
They've paired up with the company Aobag, which not only collects and sorts recycling for residents, but also pays them for it.
I've earned around 30-something yuan, not including this lot. Here's maybe another, up to 12 yuan. Anyway, these are things we don't want, so it's income, and it means there's less trash.
Aobag has developed an app to teach residents what can and cannot be recycled. It also lets them know if they've made a mistake.
We took pictures first, and the picture got sent to the user's phone. In the past, we don't know whether we do good thing or bad thing. There's no feedback, but the system we built, that we can provide feedback, not only in recyclable, but also in every category.
The company collects over a dozen types of materials, fabrics and soft plastics, as well as the usual glass and paper. Since starting out 4 years ago, they've scaled up operations with hundreds of drop-off points in Chengdu alone.
Aobag will pick up to 800 of these bags a day. That means over the course of 2 weeks, about 100 of these bundles, each weighing about a ton, and that's just of cardboard.
It's a model powered by profit, materials sold on to downstream processes. A model the company argues is more effective. But as the country aims for an ambitious target of 60% household recycling in 4 years, it may be less of a competition and more of a race, with tons still to sort through. Nicole, CGTN.